A very good evening to everyone. Today I'm going to present a topic on 3D printing, a newfangled wave in forensic odontology. As we know that 3D printing has a crucial role in each and every field. It also includes dentistry, where we can see implants or other craniomaxillofacial implants, everything. It also has a forensic role in forensic odontology, but most of them are not aware of it. Coming on to the 3D printing, it is originally referred as a rapid prototyping, which is now referred as a additive manufacturing. That is a procedure through which 3D object is generated by a consecutive layer of materials under a computer control. There are three terminologies in 3D printing. First is the 3D model, which utilizes the software designs like CAD designs, which is a mathematical representation. And next is the additive layer printing, which utilizes the curved triangulation from which a volumetric data is formed. And then the third one is the 3D scanning, which utilizes the data based on the shapes. That generally 3D printers do not use a DICOM. Instead, they use a standard stellation languages. That is, it forms a spaces, it forms a surface around which a space is created, and through which they defines the certain triangulation of form and which gives the 3D images. What are the principles in 3D printing? First one is the image attestation. That is, the images are created by the CT scans, which should be of high contrast, high resolution, and signal to noise ratio should also be high. The thickness, it should be of 1.25 mm. And if there is an increase in thickness, there will be an accuracy will be compromised. Then the second process is the image post-processing, where the images are they converted into the standard stellation formatted, that is the in the triangulation format, which gives the volumetric data. From this, it moves on to the final process of 3D printing, where the STL formats are encoded, and then with the help of resins and polymers, the 3D models are fabricated. And finally, the post-processing, that is how the finishing, polishing is done. Coming on to the forensic medicine, how it is utilized. First, the specimen is retrieved from the graveyard or mortuary, and then it is converted into CD data, and then to the 3D software using the STL format, and then finally to the 3D printing. There are various technologies and printers or works. That is PolyJet, which uses Object 500 on Konix printers, then stereolithoscopy, which uses Project 7000, then fused deposition modeling technology, which uses Fortex 400MC, then binder jetting, which uses Project 660 Pro, and then laser sintering, and then sheet laminations. Coming on to the application part, how it is used in forensic odontology, mainly in case of bite marks, that is, since soft tissues are inadequate for the long-term preservation, digital scanning of the bite marks will give the exact dentition of the victims and or the rapists. Then the second is bone patterning. By creating a bone pattern, we can see the fractures or any other defects in the bone. And then the facial reconstruction, where the from the skeletal system to the facial structures are constructed. And then age estimation, because certain bone structures are different at different ages. Then in sex determination, mainly in case of mandible, the gonial angles. That is, in case of female, it will be of a higher angle, that is 110 to 120 degree. But in case of male, it is of 90 degree. And jugoscopy, and finally kelioscopy. By creating the exact 3D printed model of the lips, we can print the lip prints, from which the lip prints can be estimated. Coming on to the merits and demerits. The merits are, it is easily presentable in the code. It is a complex part, can be measured. Easy learning and identification, non-invasive nature, and rapid prototyping. Though it has a merits, it also has a demerits. That is, limited materials, restricted build size, post-processing of processes, and a disadvantage is one. And then complex technology and large volume. Thus, I come concluding my topic by saying that though there are certain demerits are there, but the advantages are more. And we are also involving in the new technology. The forensic odontologist should be aware of the technology and utilize this for the medical legal cases. Thank you, sir.